Hello, and this is Harold again from Hidden Room Studio. Last week in the live stream, I made a hip hop beat, and this is a little update on how I finished it during the week. To see some difference, I first made export from the original one I made in the live stream, and so just let me compare, or let me show you what the difference is. For example, in the intro, I'm starting with the new one. The finished one, and in the middle, after about four bars, I switch back to the original. Original. So I changed some things and I also retuned the whole thing. What I first did when I went to finishing the beat, I took the sample I used, and tuned it up by four semitones. So this is this track here, it's called Sample Live. And if I go here, and you might see up here in the, I don't know if it's called the edit or something, that line here, you can transpose it. Let me just show you how that sounds. So you can transpose it right away on the fly while you play it. So this is four up. And this is the original, zero. And you can transpose it wherever you want. So I used four up just for some change in the sound. So to make it a little bit different than the original, to make it more sound like a sample. And I have a lot of MIDI and instrument tracks here, so I had to also retune them. And I did that with the same function. I did not go to transpose or something like that, but if I click here on the bass, you will see it, transpose plus four here. So what you just do, you go here and select them all, and then you transpose. Go here. The bass. This is now the original and plus four. But you have to be careful with that, because that can distract you in a way, because this function is only using the transport while playing the track. It's not changing the MIDI notes. So this is now transposed by four. And if I double click here and look at the inspector, I can see here this is an A. The original is an A minor, but I transposed it four up. So one, two, three, four. What you hear is when I play it, it's not A minor, it's C sharp. So the problem is when you work like this, you have to be really careful and also watch what you did, because if you give this arrangement to somebody else and he wants to play over it and is looking at the notes, he thinks that this is A, and then is playing something completely maybe out of tune because he thinks we are in A minor here. So I did this transposing for all the tracks except for the drums. Naturally, because you don't want to transpose the drums, because it may sound totally off. And what else did I do here? I used the sample that I had in the beginning, the chopped sample, in the groove agent, and changed it a little bit. I found it a little bit too boring what I played here, so I changed the notes. For example, here the chops, I made it a little longer, so I have a little longer chops, and because this is exclusive mode, it will cut whenever I go to another pad here. And I also transpose, you can see here, four semitones, all the pads by four semitones. And what else I did is I just panned it left and right, because the original sample was everything in the middle and I want to make the whole thing wider. So just let me listen to the first one again. Let's go here. This is the original one, and listen to the sample, what's playing in the middle. Here everything is in the middle, and that's the old one and the new one. It's panned left and right differently, so the individual notes or chops are coming from different directions. Thank you. to make it a little bit wider and more interesting for the listener. So what else did I change? I changed something in the arrangement here. I played around a little bit. And then in the original, that deep bass wasn't running all the time, but it didn't give me that deep fundamental bass that I needed. So I kept it for all the parts. And I changed the Wurlitzer here a little bit, that it's not coming at the end of a part, but on the beginning of a part. So to address more that it's a new part here. What else did I change? That's almost all I did. I did a little bit with the mix in the mix bus. Let me show you this, the mix bus here. Where's my mix bus? I used the loop mesh and the stereo enhancer. I made everything a little bit wider in the mix bus, and I used the loop mesh for some effects on the breakdown. So when you go from the second hook to the breakdown, I have the tape stop effect. Let me show you. To make it more interesting, to have a little change here. And when I'm coming out of the breakdown to the next part, I have some kind of scratch or another tape stop effect. Oh, that did it. That little scratch from the loop mesh. And I did that by automating the loop mesh. That means, let me go here, let me show you in the mix bus. Just in the complete mix bus, not only in the effects or in the instruments or drums or something in a subgroup. I have it in a complete mix bus, so the whole music is going through the loop mesh. And what I did is I just let it run, and then I clicked here on the effect I needed while I was in automation write mode. And then you can see here down is a lane. Here you can see that. This is in a mix bus, is the automation lane for the loop mesh. And I just selected it and quantized it on the grid. And also put here on, I think it's quarter notes, so that it's timed to the music. So I made a little change here, and this is one of the major changes, and I think one of the big changes I made compared to the live version is that I changed the sample, which is running here in the breakdown alone, so you can hear, and also in the intro, that left and right of the sample. So that's about it. As I said, I made some changes in the arrangement, just came up with where do I go with all the individual parts. Here on the on the sample, when I'm playing the original sample, the complete sample here, I have that DJ EQ here in the track to make it in the intro sound a little bit different. Let me check where I have it here. Sample live, this is it. Sample live, here I have the DJ EQ. This is just some setting that was in one of those presets. I changed a little bit to make it more mid-rangey and get rid of the low and the high. And it's like this. So it's more mid-range. And then it's turned off here. Then it's bypassed. And in the second part here, then it's running, or the rest. It's running with everything. So that's it. That's what I did. Let's listen to the whole thing. This has been Harold from Hidden Room Studio. I hope you liked it, what I did here. And check back to my live streams every Saturday at 7:30 German time. I will announce it on my channel. The next one will be making EDM sounds with Retrolog and with Flux from Halion. And the week after that, I'm going to make a synthwave track, and in 3 weeks' time, I'm going to make a session about the Curve EQ, which is not a Steinberg plugin, but is coming with Cubase, and it's a mastering and mixing EQ, a very special one. So let's run this through, and if you liked it, subscribe, hit the button, the bell button, leave a message, leave a comment, and see you next time. Goodbye.